Okay, now I love this part. We just got talking about this, just finished talking about the three descending negatives or the three levels to avoid. Walking in the counsel of the wicked, standing in the way of sinners, sitting in the seat of mockers. And all of that now gives way to the positive, to the positive. And you remember in verse 2, look at it with me. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. So I've avoided those three descending negatives, those three descending values. I've avoided those. And what else would I do but delight in the law of the Lord, aka instruction of the Lord, the engineering of the Lord, the heart of the Lord, the ways of the Lord. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. That is why I've challenged you to memorize with me Psalm 1. By doing that, you're meditating. You are putting good stuff in, good organic stuff in that will grow and give fruit in your life. You'll be clear. You'll be clear. You'll be strong if you do that. You won't be wishy-washy. You'll be a person who's on a path towards the residence and the heart of God. And I love this part. He, the one who meditates on the instructions and the ways of God, he is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season and whose leaf does not wither. Let me talk to you about this just for a little bit. First of all, the person who pursues God's instructions becomes blessed in at least four ways. Number one, they grow over time. Verse three, the first part says, he's like a tree. Trees grow, planted by streams of water. Especially trees that are planted by streams of water. So when we pursue the instructions and the wisdom of God, we grow over time just like a tree. Our roots grow, they grow deeper and stronger, providing us more water and nutrients, as well as increased strength from the winds that come against us in this life. And our core, trunk, if you will, and our branches also grow bigger and stronger, protecting us from the harsh elements, winters, summers, even drought. So the first thing that happens that we get blessed is we grow. We grow over time. We may not be able to notice growth from one day to the next, but like a tree, when we come back one summer after another, we've grown and we can see it. The second is that we bless others. The person who meditates on God's word, they become a blessing to others because they're filled with nutrients that turns out and bears fruit. At the minimum, leaves, which gives shade, but often apples and oranges and all kinds of different fruit, literal fruit that one can nourish themselves with. A tree bears fruit primarily for the good of those outside of oneself. The branches provide the shade and the fruit and the nourishment for other living things. Isn't that amazing? As you become stronger, you become a blessing to other people. So you grow over time, and then you become a blessing to other people. The third thing that happens is that you are able to overcome life's challenges and difficulties. Jesus said that in this world you will have trouble. It's a fact. It's going to happen. You're either going in a storm, you're in a storm, or you're coming out of a storm. But we will be able to grow life's challenges. The third part of verse 3 says, and whose leaf does not wither. So in other words, it's not talking about the falling of leaves in the autumn, in the autumn season, but what it's talking about is during times of drought, during times of difficulties, when other trees fade and die and plants, we make it through the drought. We make it through the storms because we become strong, much like the oak trees that we see in our country. Isn't that great? And then the fourth blessing is that we prosper. We prosper. The last part of verse 4 says, whatever he does prospers. Now, most people enjoy doing life with people they can trust. They can trust. You're going to put a swing on the branch of a tree that you believe is strong enough. That is strong enough. You're going to keep a tree that bears fruit. You're going to look forward to the next season where the tree brings forth fruit. So just like a well-established tree, a person becomes trustworthy and counted on. They prosper in all their endeavors.